You've saved me.
Expert in dealing pain and derangement, sort of like you. We can show you what it's like to be on the other end of it.
Stand, man of the West!
You maggot!
Pretty grim, isn't it? This place is just darkness and misery. But on the bright side, I can put an end to it. For you, anyway.
Come get us all, fool! I'll drink your blood!
Oh.
you're injured.
It's nothing. You saved us. Again.
You were right. Staying in Mordor is certain doom. But I cannot leave.
My lady.
Then we will be doomed. Together.
something.
Like the elves, Sauron values wisdom above all else. But for him, it is a cold, hard thing. He believes freedom is an empty virtue. He believes that Middle-earth seeks perfection in order. He believes that he will achieve what those before him could not.
This, she speaks the truth.
Never thought I'd hear you say that.
Sauron understood that power did not come from arms, but the willingness to sacrifice, to lie in wait. This is the truth he taught me, and so I lie in wait. And when the day comes, I will make my sacrifice.
me your metal!
Little of the Harrigan, mostly folk tales told around the campfire. The stories say they are fierce, pitiless warriors, as cruel as the orcs and as stern as the southern mountains beyond which they hail. Those folk tales convince many a Gondorian child to behave, but I cannot reconcile them with what I see in the only Harrigan I know, Baranor. He is fierce in battle and stern when needs must, but cruel? Never.
Such strange thing.
And yet to the men of the south, it is as ordinary as your tunic. Only distance makes this precious.
You can find yourself all alone.
Made for a slot! Got you!
the globe!
They love pain. It's time for them to feel some of their own.
I don't bother.
good are we?
You will kneel!
Something.
It is a fundamental truth of Mordor. The orcs have been here far longer than men. Far longer than the Dark Lord himself, even. This place belongs to them. And in their own way, the orcs revere their heritage. We found this sword in a crude shrine, after all. Yet imagine what the orcs and Mordor could become if freed of the Dark Lord's corruption.
The orcs can temper a blade, I'll give them that.
They produce weapons in mass, but they give little care to each one.
Feel it!
Minas Ethel held many treasures far grander than this necklace, though none more precious to me. When I was a little girl, I would sneak into the Great Hall and take this necklace from its locked cabinet, thanks to a loose latch that only a child's hand could reach. For hours, I would admire myself in the mirror, imagining myself an elegant lady of Gondor, much like my mother must have been. My father caught me eventually, but as punishment, I received only a lecture. Perhaps he didn't mind seeing his daughter in such finery.
I'm surprised this necklace isn't hanging from some orc's neck.
Perhaps their stubby fingers cannot work such a delicate clasp.
The Analects of Ruvenir is a collection of advice from a long-ago Gondorian swordsman. It includes a series of exercises he guaranteed would lead to triumph in every duel. Like all young Gondorian soldiers, I studied the Analects a great deal, and I learned two key things. One, Ruvenir's swordsmanship was undoubtedly better than his penmanship. And two, in Ruvenir's time, duelists were far more courteous than the orcs of Mordor. War ignores such niceties.
A treatise on fine swordsmanship.
All too rare in these times. Such grace is lost on the denizens of Mordor.
Ferrier. Abdicate your will!
The Nazgul is holding some of your followers.
We must recover them.
Such loyalty to the Orcs.
It's almost ritualistic murder!
Set me free before they cut me apart!
I see the Ranger!
He's nearly sacrificed!
To the Witch King.
This will be good.
Yield and rid yourself of this ring.
Set me free before they cut me apart! got no patience. Those shriekers nearly offed me.
Our army remains strong, and we have all but assured the Nazgul cannot track us.
But they are still not defeated. As long as they are out there, we are not safe. You least of all.
Our followers are returned and the Hydea are secure. The Nazgul's power is diminished.
And yet, this sense of dread grows.